From Opera to Pop, The History of Musical Theater by Maria F. Puig. Have you heard of The Lion King? How about Dear Evan Hansen? Or even Phantom of the Opera? You might be asking, what do these completely different works of performance art have in common? The answer is, they all belong to the art form that is musical theater, where dance, song, and theater come together to convey a story. This art form has evolved tremendously through the centuries, and maybe you'll learn that your favorite music has been used in a piece of musical theater. Now, as they say in Sound of Music, let's start from the very beginning. The earliest forms of musical theater trace back to ancient Greece, where the Greeks used song and movement to convey a story. Fast forward to the Renaissance, where music and theater was first used for liturgical purposes and then for extravagant performances that are now known as operas. The first musical to be performed in America was The Black Crook. It premiered in New York City on September 12, 1866. In the 1920s, the American musical evolved to a vaudeville or cabaret style, meaning it was more about the show-stopping numbers and less about the plot. Some examples of this are The Ziegfeld Follies and Shuffle Along. In 1927, the musical Showboat was the first to tackle strong subjects like racial injustice. Slowly, musicals returned their focus to plot. The 1940s is considered the start of the musical golden age. During this time, the art form created such classics as Oklahoma, Sound of Music, and West Side Story. Musicals such as Fiddler on the Roof used beautiful dance numbers to tell us the story of a Jewish community struggling to keep their traditions, while musicals like A Chorus Line showed us that you don't need elaborate sets and flashy costumes to entertain and convey a heartwarming story about the members of the chorus. In 1947, the American Theater Wing established the Tony Awards to celebrate excellence in theater. The end of the Golden Age is a topic debated by many experts. Some say the end came after A Chorus Line, others say it ended with the controversial musical Hair, due to its absurd amount of profanity, which was completely different to the wholesome happy endings of the musical Golden Age. Even though the Golden Age in America had ended, on the other side of the Atlantic, British writers were developing new styles of musical theater, such as rock musicals like the cult classic Rocky Horror Show, and pop musicals like Phantom of the Opera. Both of these add a modern twist to classical music. These musicals were made as mega musicals, which means they had large budgets and used technologically advanced sets, lighting, and special effects. Nowadays, musicals are written in classic styles, such as Thoroughly Modern Millie, or be hip-hop operas about the Founding Fathers, better known as the Tony-winning musical Hamilton. Modern musicals also include jukebox musicals, which are musicals that use popular music from an era or an artist to tell a story. Examples of this are Mamma Mia, which uses ABBA music, and Jersey Boys, which tells the story of Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons with their own music. Modern musicals also use stronger themes, like Rent, which talks about AIDS. Modern musicals have a wide variety of styles, and with today's technology, when putting on a stage show, the sky's the limit. All in all, musical theater is an ancient art form that has evolved to fit the time period they were created in, even today. Because of this, there is a musical for classic music enthusiasts, to pop music lovers, and everything in between. So go out there and find your musical.